how do I buy a CPU? What do I look for? What is good? What is bad? Well, the first thing that you need to figure out is what are you going to be using your computer for? If it's gaming, there's a certain set of specifications you're looking for. If it's video editing, there's a separate specification. If you're just browsing the internet, you can do that on a potato. But you need to figure out what you're going to do it for and whether or not that is a single-threaded or multi-threaded performance. What does that mean? Well, a CPU is split into cores, and each core has a clock speed. And if the program that you're using can't take advantage of multiple cores and multiple threads, don't spend the money on it. Get a faster CPU that has a lower core count, because you're never going to see the added performance from those multiple cores. That's a lot of words. So what's a core? Video up there somewhere in the description will tell you exactly what a CPU does. But a good rule of thumb is to take the clock speed and multiply it by the core count. The larger the number, the better the CPU is going to be. Obviously, gigantic asterisk next to that, because it depends on what you're using your CPU for, but a good rule of thumb is to start there. After that, do some research, look at the programs that you use. A lot of times, like Adobe's website will have recommendations of what they think would be best in your system if you're using Adobe products. If you're doing gaming, each game that you play will have a recommendation of what they think is the best system for you. Also, check out PC Part Picker. There are some incredible builds there. Also, you can put together your entire build and it will tell you whether or not it will actually work together, which is an incredible value, on its own. So let's actually buy a CPU. So looking at AMD processors, because I know I want to go AMD because I get a better performance per dollar spent. And I actually went with this one. This is a AMD Ryzen 7 3800X. It's an 8-core CPU with a base clock of 3.9 gigahertz and a boost clock of 4.5 gigahertz. Let's break that down. So AMD is the company that makes the CPU. Ryzen 7 is just the each category or range of CPUs has a number to it. So Ryzen 3, Ryzen 5, Ryzen 7, Ryzen 9. Higher the number, the better the CPU. Also, the more expensive the CPU. 3800X. Well, the 3 that starts that number means it's a third-gen Ryzen CPU. It means it's the newest one at the filming of this video. 3800, 3 is the generation, and then the 800 is also a model number. So the larger that number, the better the CPU. There is a 3700X that has a lower clock speed and a lower boost clock, the same number of cores, but I wanted a higher clock speed, so I went with the 3800. The X means that this CPU does not have graphics attached to it. This CPU requires a dedicated graphics card to render anything out on the screen. And then it's an 8-core CPU, means there's 8 tiny little processors on that. Each one of those processors can be split into 2 threads, and then the clock speeds are how quickly it can go. Gaming uses more clock speed, won't necessarily use more cores. Video editing will use more cores and more clock speed. There's a lot of, do your research. Google what you do, try to find a guide out there. There's some awesome ones on PC Part Picker. There's also an incredible company called Puget Systems that tests all this stuff for you. You can follow their guides as well. Hopefully that was useful. If I was wrong about any of that, let me know down in the comments. If you were to buy a CPU today, what would you go with? What is your dream CPU? You have unlimited budget, what would you buy? Let me down in the comments below. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification button, be part of that Noti squad, and until next time, we'll see you later.